Good morning and welcome to today's International Space Station Update Hour. You're joining us now inside of the International Space Station Flight Control Room here in Houston, Texas, where the Orbit 2 team is currently on console, monitoring systems on board the orbiting laboratory. Today's team is being led today by veteran Flight Director Tony Sakachi, and joining him at the Capcom console is Hal Getzelman, serving as the comm link between controllers here on the ground and the crew up in space. And that crew right now is Expedition 30, and you can see them right here. That Expedition 30 crew being led in the front row left by NASA astronaut Dan Burbank, and immediately behind him, Russian cosmonauts Anton Shkaplerov and Anatoly Ivanishin. Continuing across the back row is European Space Agency astronaut Andrei Kuipers and NASA astronaut Don Pettit. And then in the front right is the third Russian cosmonaut, Oleg Kononenko. So, fairly busy day today for the crew on board following an off-duty day yesterday, starting off with Commander Burbank, who immediately began his day conducting a conductivity test with some of the electrical systems for the waste and hygiene compartment. This was being done following some voltage discrepancies that were noted last week by controllers here on the ground with the urine monitoring system. And aside from this work on the waste and hygiene compartment today, Commander Burbank will be participating in an educational event with the O. Henry Middle School in Austin, Texas. Joining him will be NASA astronaut Don Pettit and European astronaut Andrei Kuipers. That'll happen here in just a little while at about 10:20 a.m. Central Time, 11:20 a.m. Eastern. Meanwhile, Russian cosmonaut Anton Shkaplerov started his day doing some research studies on the veins in the lower extremities of his own body, and then later in the day doing a power supply swap alongside Anatoly Ivanishin. Aside from that power supply swap today, Ivanishin has been working with the Matryoshka experiment, which is a Russian research into the amount of radiation that the astronauts' bodies are exposed to during these long-duration space flights. He was taking a number of readings from the mannequin-sized doll with a number of dosimeters inside. And he was joined throughout that by his fellow and third Russian cosmonaut, Oleg Kononenko. And while joining Ivanishin in that, Kononenko has also been working on the Russian relaxation experiment today. And this is a research study into determining the effects of various propulsion system exhausts on the Earth's upper atmosphere. And then it also looks at their effect on optically sensitive surfaces on board the station, such as windows, equipment lenses, and solar array panels. European Space Agency astronaut Andrei Kuipers started his day rearranging a few payloads in the Express Rack 1, focusing on the NanoRacks Platform 2 payload. And then a little bit later today, he'll be working with the VO2 Max, which looks to study the respiratory capabilities of astronauts, taking a number of readings both before, during, and after their long-duration space flights. He'll be setting up some of the system equipment to take those readings. Then the final crew member of Expedition 30, Don Pettit, is doing some weekly cleaning and housekeeping tasks, trying to keep the station in clean and working order, before doing some work with the microgravity science glove box. He'll be changing out a laptop that helps to control many of the experiments inside. That glove box is used to provide a sealed environment to conduct various experiments, including biotechnology, combustion science, life sciences, fluid physics, fundamental physics, and material science. And then following all these activities, the crew will end their day with a daily planning conference before moving into their scheduled sleep period at about 4:30 p.m. Central Time.